So what is the most effective treatment for nonspecific chronic low back pain? We finally have an answer, and the answer is... yes. A systematic review and network meta-analysis found that there was low quality evidence for Pilates, stabilization and motor control exercises, resistance training, and aerobic exercise, which really isn't all that helpful necessarily, because that's a whole lot of exercises that can be used for non-specific chronic low back pain. But let's dig into this article a little bit. So this article was published in the British Journal of Sports Medicine by Owen, and it looked at different types of exercise for chronic low back pain. And there were 89 studies that were included in the systematic review, 55 studies for the pairwise meta-analysis, and then 82 studies for the network meta-analysis. So they looked at a couple of different outcomes that exercise had an effect on. So obviously we looked at pain, they also looked at physical function, mental health, muscle strength, and also muscle endurance. There were 70 studies that looked at pain as an outcome, and what this study found was that Pilates, stabilization and motor control exercises, resistance training, aerobic training, multimodal, so a combination of these various types of exercise, as well as other, and I don't actually know what the other category is exactly. It's classified as an exercise that doesn't fit into one of these categories, so I actually don't really know what exercise type that actually is, but they found that all of these exercises were effective in reducing pain in chronic low back pain. Of all of these, they found that Pilates, aerobic exercise, as well as stabilization and motor control exercises were probably the most likely to be effective of all of these categories. There were 63 studies that looked at physical function as an outcome measure, and what this study found was that stabilization and motor control exercises, resistance training, aerobic training, water-based therapies, yoga, Pilates, and also the other category, again, were all effective in improving physical function when compared to a true control. Of all of these therapies, they concluded that stabilization and motor control exercises, as well as resistance training, were most likely to be the most effective of all of these exercise types. And then when looking at mental health, there were 24 studies that looked at mental health as the outcome. And what they found was that resistance training, aerobic training, and stabilization and motor control exercises were the most effective at improving mental health. And then of these therapies, they found that resistance training and aerobic training were most likely to be the most effective of all the exercise types. In summary, what this article found was that Pilates was the most effective for pain relief. Resistance training and stabilization and motor control exercises were the most effective for improving physical function. And then resistance training and aerobic training were the most effective for improving mental health. And all of these were based on low quality evidence. And when reflecting on the results of this study, there are a couple of surprises, although we have to keep in mind that these were all based on low quality evidence. And one is that when we look at pain, Pilates was the most effective, and while that could change with some higher quality evidence, it's interesting because Pilates typically isn't recommended in a lot of healthcare settings where we're actually walking people through Pilates. Maybe we refer out to Pilates, but you know, with this kind of evidence, maybe we should start including some Pilates into our treatment approaches. With that being said, resistance training, aerobic training, and a bunch of those other, the spinal stabilization exercises, they were all also effective treatment options for pain as well. It just, they weren't the most effective. And so, the article mentions that we have some flexibility in what we can actually prescribe. So it's going to depend on the patient on what they're going to do. If it's somebody who's not going to do Pilates, it does us no good to recommend them to do Pilates. And so, we can use aerobic training or resistance training as possible pain-relieving exercises to help with those with chronic low back pain. And unfortunately, again, when reflecting on this article, no exercise was really all that great in this article, and it was all based on low-quality evidence. So it doesn't really help us kind of guide specifically which exercise is most effective for either pain or physical function, or mental health, or even strength or endurance. there tends to be a bunch of different exercises that we can use. Well, yes, that's a benefit because we're not stuck into one treatment. We can kind of pick which one is best suited for the patient, but the fact that none of them are all that helpful overall is a little bit problematic, and part of that can stem from, well, if it's non-specific chronic low back pain, we don't really know the cause, and so we probably need a little bit more information on what is driving chronic low back pain to actually be able to figure out what treatments are appropriate. And this article supports that active therapies are the most effective treatment option that we have for non-specific chronic low back pain. And this is even in comparison to hands-on therapies, such as manual therapy, as well as hands-off therapies, such as just general advice. And so when we're treating chronic low back pain, we need to take an active approach. It's just we don't know which approach we should actually be taking that is the most effective.